Peters. Here, in this chapter, in this poem, we will learn about the kittens and their names with the poet beside as per the qualities and characteristics of the kittens. So, first of all, we will start with the first stanza. So, the first stanza is, our old cat has kittens three. Means, the cat had three kittens, the young ones of the cat. What do you think their names should be? Now, the poet is too confused about the names of the kittens. The poet is not able to give a suitable name to the kittens. So, first of all, the poet will tell the characteristics of the kitten. And as per the qualities only, he will give a suitable name to the kitten. One is tabby with amber eyes, and a tail that's long and slender. And into a tadpole she quickly flies, if you ever by chance offend her. I think we shall call her cat. Now, don't you think that Pepperpot is a nice name for a cat? Now, students, these are the lines of the first stanza. Now, one is Tabby with amber eyes. Tabby means a brown and black colored cat. And his eyes are of which color? Green color. Okay, bright green color. And her tail, the cat has a tail that is very long and slender, very thin. And into a temper, she quickly flies. And then, when the cat is very furious, very angry, that time she quickly flies. And if you ever by chance offend her, and sometimes if you make the cat upset, then also she quickly run away from the place. I think we shall call her name. Now the poet is just thinking the name for a kitten, a suitable name for a kitten as per these characteristics of the kitten. Now he is too confused that what would be the suitable name for the kitten. I think we shall call her this. That's why the poet has repeated these lines twice in each stanza, because he is too confused about the name of the kitten and he just want to give a suitable name to the kitten. I think we shall call her cat. Now, don't you think? So, after the discussion of these qualities and characteristics of the kitten, he decided that a paper pot should be a suitable name for the first kitten. So, which name he has given to the kitten? The first one, the name is Pepperpot. Now come to the second stanza. One is black with a tail of white. Now these are the characteristics of the second kitten of the cat. And her feet are all white fur. If you stop her, she carries her tail upright and quickly begins to purr. I think we shall call her this. I think we shall call her that. Don't you think that Soup King is a nice name for a cat? Now after the explanation of these qualities of the kitten, now the poet again decided a suitable name for the second kitten. So, what are the qualities of the second kitten? The cat is black in color and has a face of white color. And her feet are all white fur. And on the second kitten's feet, there were white furs. And if you stroke her, if you hit her, she carries her tail upright. Okay, then afterwards, she makes this sound. I think we shall call her this. Now again, after the explanation of the qualities of the kitten, the poet again focusing on the name of the kitten, a suitable name of the kitten. So, I think we shall call her this. I think we shall call her that. Because he has too many things in his mind. That's why the poet is too confused about the name of the kitten. yellow and black. With plenty of vibes about him. If you please him at once, he sets up his back. He is powerful one. Never doubt him. Now still this is. And he, then apostrophe ER. This is the word. Never. Okay? Never doubt him. I think we shall follow these. Again, the poet has done the repetition of these two lines. Why? Two. Because he is focusing on the name of the kitten. That's why he has repeated these lines again and again in all the stanzas. I think we shall call her this. I think we shall call her that. Now, don't you think that's snatch away is a nice name for her cat? So, after the discussion of the qualities of the third kitten, the poet has given a suitable name to the third kitten. And what was the name? Scratch. Okay? So, now come to the expression for the third stanza, students. One is tortoise shell. If you have seen the shell of the tortoise, the shell is very hard. Okay? And it is of which color? Brown color. So, the color of the third kitten is brown because of this yellow and black. So, the kitten is of this color. With plenty of white about him and on his body, the vice of white color is also there. If you tease him, if you irritate him, if you annoy him, at once he sets up his back, he would become angry. He is quarrelsome. Means he is very good in quarreling with others. Never doubt him. And there is no doubt that he would avoid the things. If you will annoy the kitten, that he will forgive you. No. He is quarrelsome. I think now after the discussion of these qualities, the poet is just thinking a suitable name for the kitten. I think we shall call for this. For these qualities, this name should be suitable. And maybe that name should be suitable. Then afterwards, what did he say? The poet, now don't you think that scratch away, what is the name he has given? Scratch away is a nice name for the cat. So students, three kittens for there, okay? And three names also we get for the kittens. The first name was Pepper Pot for the first kitten. Second name was the Suitcase. And the third name was the Scratch Away. As per the characteristics of the kittens. Now, students, if you will look at the last verse of each line, then you will get the rhyming words of this poem or the rhyme scheme also. Okay? As I told you that in the poem, if you want to know the rhyme scheme or the rhyming words of the poem, then you have to look at the last verse of each line. So, here, of this stanza, what will you take? Eyes. Slander. Are they rhyming? No. They both have different sounds. Flies. Eyes. Flies. They are rhyming. Eyes. Flies. They both are rhyming. So these are the rhyming words. Her. This. That. Paper coat. Cat. That and cat. That cat. Again they both are rhyming. So here of this stanza we got two rhyming words. A pair of two rhyming words. The first pair is eyes and flies, and the second one is cat and that. In the same manner, you can also identify the rhyming words of the other two stanzas. So, students, I hope the poem is clear to you. This poem is about the names of the kitten. So, that's all in this lesson, students.